The parotid gland, one of the major salivary glands, is located in front of the ear. It is intimately associated with the facial nerve, which originates from behind the ear and spreads outward to innervate all the muscles of the face. With any type of parotid gland surgery, anatomic knowledge of the facial nerve and its branches are essential in order to minimize risk of facial paralysis from any unintentional damage to the nerve. The main facial nerve trunk originates from behind and below the ear before it divides into five main branches. The temporal branch controls the forehead muscle. The zygomatic branch helps close your eye. The buccal branch moves the upper lip to make a smile, whereas the marginal mandibular branch moves the lower lip to express a frown. The cervical branch controls the platysma muscle, which covers the neck and chin. Most masses that develop in the parotid gland are due to benign tumors such as a pleomorphic adenoma or a Warthin's tumor. Although non-cancerous, they do become larger over time and as such, are typically removed before it becomes disfiguring. More rarely, cancerous growths can also occur. When a parotid mass is removed, the surgeon cannot simply remove the growth without taking into consideration where the facial nerve branches are. The parotid mass may be below the facial nerve. The facial nerve may even go through the parotid mass itself. Fortunately, the most common scenario is that the facial nerve branches get spread apart by the parotid mass. In order to minimize risk of accidentally cutting the facial nerve resulting in paralysis, the surgeon must first carefully identify all branches of the facial nerve around the mass using careful dissection. Afterwards, the mass, only at this point, can be removed safely and confidently.